Alright everybody, this is Lilith Keep Hard Mode. I'll be walking you through the mystic aspect of it today. This is a healer intense dungeon. It's not really relying much on the DPS and them knowing the mechanics. This point in the game, they released this with the same stats as it had back in the day. So day one release, this is still a 417. All these high levels, we will fly right through this. At least with my mystic buffs, which you guys will see, make these guys hit so much harder. Now we're getting started. Natural enrage, throwing contagion on her. This mechanics, how annoying, I will kill you. You stand in front of her till she does that, then you get dead behind her. The flame will turn you into ashes. He runs off because as this boss progresses, a fire goes around the circle here. We have to fight in there, and that doesn't disappear. Ooh, I should not have done that. He's gonna put it right in the middle of the circle. See, you don't do that. I'll show you why here in a second. It's gonna get pretty intense for me and the tank. Yeah, I believe it's 10%. She spawns adds a fight alongside her instead of her taking off. Guys get a bomb on them when they go in there. Normally we have the whole circle to fight in. Tank, be quiet, bud. Normal mode, the hardening wax goes a lot slower, so you gotta watch it, especially as a healer. On a priest side, it's a little bit more difficult because their cleanse entails them being all together if he's gonna get them in a big group, I believe. Don't take my word on that. I don't main a priest. I don't know what the priest moves are, but I do know that it goes up a lot faster. In a lot of cases, most of the DPS can live through the explosion, but some can't. So you want to make sure that you are ready and have them all cleansed like so. Everybody get out. Kind of a sloppy run there. That was my bad. Make sure you get everybody. Get them out of there. Oh, my bad, buddy. This is where it gets intense. You mess up on this mechanic in this one and everybody wipes. And seeing how they messed the vow up on council, I wait until right around the time that that happens to even put the vow out, just in case I mess up, because sometimes you just do, especially as a mystic. Sometimes she runs too far, you know what I'm saying, you just don't get it in time. It's happened. That's all I'm saying. This is the only one that you can iframe through, I believe, is the last one. At least the only one worth iframing through, because the other two don't hurt you that bad if you get caught in them. But that last one will fuck your life up. Excuse my language. You gotta make sure you cleanse the hell out of these guys in the middle, because it's like 20% a tick, I believe. That's got a bleed effect on it. You don't want to be in that either. Rest soon. If you don't get this mechanic right here, you pull out the totem there. You get up here, you dispel. See, I don't know if I got it there. It's not good. Looks like she ran away. Yep. See, I put the vow up just in case. Got it on me and him. That's a just in case. Imagine that's actually a good trap of all traps kind of run here. Out of this. Make sure you get your buffs back on. Like I said, there's a bleed effect on that. You want to stay out. Where's this other guy at? Gotta be close enough. There's the tank, so I know to stay with him. Cause she'll come running right at him for aggro. And bam. As of right now, I can't find the third guy. Or the third DPS. I don't know, he didn't run outside, that's for sure. Is he right under them? Oh, he's right there. Yeah, I can't get him. He got shot outside. That's bad for him because I can't get him. Thank you.
Master, my life is yours.